Shekalim Perek Dalid Mishnah Gimel, third Mishnah in the fourth chapter of Shekalim. We're going to continue to discuss what do they do with the money that they collected. The Mishnah says, Motar Shiarei Halishkah. Shiarei Halishkah is what's left. Remember, they took the money and they paid it from, they took it out of the boxes and they did the Terumat Halishkah. The Terumah, they took it and brought it into the office, into the Lishkah. And then they designated that money for the stuff that they needed, for the Korbanot and the things that we learned in the last Mishnah. So what do they do with the extra, the Shiarei Halishkah, the extra leftovers of the Lishkah? Mahayu Osi Behem. What would they do? Lochim Behem Yenot Shmanim Uslatot. They would buy wine, shem and oils, slatot. Those are not salat like Hebrew. It's solet. It's solet. It's fine flowers. Those things were items that people needed in order to offer their offerings in the Beit HaMikdash. V'asachar lehegdis. So what they would do, let's look at the Bar Tinura. So they buy these things. U'mochim otam lemisha tzarich yayin lenesachim. They would sell them, whoever needs wine, ushmanim or oils, uslatot limanachot. They would open a little makolet. They would open a Beit HaMikdash makolet. V'asachar lehegdis. And then the extra money went to hegdish. Divei Rabbi Yishmael. That's what Rabbi Yishmael said, that they would use that money in order to support their little, the makolet in the Beit HaMikdash, so people would know what to buy. Rabbi Akiva Omer, Rabbi Akiva says, Ein mistachrin mishal hegdish v'lo mishal aniyim. Sorry, we don't use money, we don't invest hegdish or benefit from hegdish. Says Bar Tinura, Ein mistachrin mishal hegdish. She'ein aniyut b'makom ashirut. There is no poverty where there is wealth. Uganayhu lehegdish. I think Rabbi Akiva sensed that it's inappropriate in the Beit HaMikdash for them to have a little makolet. You know, therefore, and you also don't do it for aniyim. You don't invest money of poor people. It's a very interesting question, because let's say you're running a fund for the aniyim. So Rabbi Akiva said it's not appropriate to take the money and invest it, because as any investor will tell you, then the money's not liquid. I mean, let's look at the Bar Tinura. Dilma mitrami aniyah, poor purpose will come. V'lek alametavla, you don't have it. I can't give you, I can't help you, because the money's invested. It's not liquid. I have to wait in order to divest the investment. So therefore, ein mistakrin, you don't make a benefit, neither from Hegdish or Mishal Aniim. I get the sense that Rabbi Kiva also felt that, you know, there's the people around the Beit HaMikdash, they lived on the Beit HaMikdash, meaning everybody came in and they got what they needed. If the Beit HaMikdash sold you everything you needed, then, you know, we'll see later on, it would be difficult for other people to survive, and there would become a sort of like a competition between the Beit HaMikdash and the people around it. I don't know, we'll see in later Mishnayot what happened, how people procure the items that they needed from the Beit HaMikdash for their covenant. Stop here and dedicate our learning to memory of Aisha Tzipora Feiga Matilda Bat Nachum Elimelech and the memory of my father, Rav Simcha Yitzchak Kalman. Have a good day.